am not ashamed to own my Lord, nor to defend his cause. Maintain the honors of his word, the glory of his cross.
Hello, I'm James Brown, and on behalf of the East End Church of Christ located in Toronto, Canada, I'd like to welcome you to Monday's edition of Walking Through the Bible, a podcast where we seek to study the Bible and the Bible alone. Please stick around afterwards for information on how you can contact us. But for now, if you have a Bible with you, please go to the book of Genesis and we'll turn you over to Jeremy Dieselkamp for our study of the day.
Thank you, James, and welcome to all of our viewers. This is the 42nd lesson in our study of Genesis. On Saturday, we covered Genesis chapter 10, verses 21 through 32, discussing the descendants of Shem. If you missed that episode and would like to watch it, you can find it and all of our other podcasts on our website at www.eastendchurch.org. You can also find them on our YouTube channel at www.youtube.com/EastEndChurchOfChrist under the Walking Through the Bible Genesis playlist. Today we're going to begin with Genesis 11, verse 1, and read through verse 9. The text that you'll see on the screen is from the English Standard Version, but you're welcome to follow along with any version that you have. So let's now read Genesis 11, beginning at verse 1. Now the whole earth had one language and the same words. And as people migrated from the east, they found a plain in the land of Shinar and settled there. And they said to one another, "Come, let us make bricks and burn them thoroughly." And they had brick for stone and bitumen for mortar. Then they said, "Come, let us build ourselves a city and a tower with its top in the heavens, and let us make a name for ourselves, lest we be dispersed over the face of the whole earth." And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower which the children of man had built. And the Lord said, "Behold, they are one people, and they have all one language, and this is only the beginning of what they will do. And nothing they propose to do will now be impossible for them. Come, let us go down there and confuse their language so that they may not understand one another's speech." So the Lord dispersed them from there over all the face of the earth, and they left off building the city. Therefore its name was called Babel, because there the Lord confused the language of all the earth. And from there the Lord dispersed them over the face of all the earth. In the last chapter, we read of the genealogies of Shem, Ham, and Japheth. Having completed reading that list, we might assume that the story we just read today occurs after this, but that assumption would be false. In fact, this story is mentioned in those genealogies when Genesis 10:25 says that during the days of Peleg, Shem's descendant, the earth was divided. Even in verse 11 of chapter 10, during our discussion of Nimrod, Ham's descendant, it was implied that something caused Nimrod to move to Assyria from Shinar, though the reason wasn't explained. We must therefore realize that this story, though it appears after the genealogical tables of chapter 10, actually occurred during the lives of some of the people contained in those lists. What this story does is answer the question of why there are so many languages. While non-Bible believers would scoff at this story as representing actual events, evidence exists that humans originally lived in Africa and the surrounding regions and spread out from there. This is something that not only the Bible supports, but specifically says in Genesis. If people lived in the same region, it would only be logical to conclude they all spoke the same language. Whether there were different languages before the flood is unknown, but remember, only Noah and his family survived, so if there were other languages, only the ones spoken by Noah's family would be present after the flood. All we need to realize to understand this chapter is that shortly after the flood, mankind's population was not that large. We lived in a relatively small region in Africa and the Middle East, and we all spoke the same language. A consequence of speaking the same language is that we were more likely to get along and more likely to be able to work together. That's what the people of that time did in Shinar, what we would call Mesopotamia. The purpose for building this city and this tower is told to us, for verse 4 says they wanted to make a name for themselves by building a tower to the heavens. If they succeeded in doing this, they claimed they wouldn't be dispersed over the earth. James 4:6 says that God opposes the proud, so it's no wonder that God was angry at the actions of the people. So as a way of preventing them from continuing along this evil path, God introduced different languages to the different families so they could no longer understand each other. He then spread them out over the face of all the earth. Even though he could have done this miraculously, I don't believe this is necessarily how he did this. Speaking different languages naturally causes people to group together with other people that they understand. You just need to look at the different big cities and countries today to know this is true. We know of land bridges that connected Southeast Asia with Australia and East Asia with North America, so it didn't require a miracle for a migration to those continents to happen. As a result of God's action, though, the city and tower was stopped. The city was known as Babel, which comes from the Hebrew word Balal, meaning confusion. With that, our time is up for today. Please join us, the Lord willing, tomorrow when we will continue our study of Genesis, beginning with Genesis 11, verse 10.
Thank you, Jeremy. And to our viewers, we also thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking on the subscribe button below. Should you have any questions or comments, please leave a comment below or email us at answerintheword@gmail.com. We'll try to respond to you as quickly as we can. We hope you'll join us, the Lord willing, tomorrow when we'll be continuing our study of the book of Genesis. Goodbye for now and have a great day.
I'm not ashamed to own my Lord.